able to capture that things. Okay. So what is the next model we have? It is a fast text. Okay. It is a library developed in C++. Actually, this library is developed by Facebook team to learn the efficient word representation and to do the sentence classification. And actually, it supports the multiple processing during the training. And it have both kind of supervised as well as unsupervised representation of your words. And actually, if you see the implementation of this fast text, then we can say that it is extension of our word to vec model. Okay. So in word to vec model, if we see the skip gram model, what it does, it predicts, means we are feeding a center word to our model, and it is going to predict the context words. Okay. So basically, it is working on your words part, but fast text, how it is different from word to vec? Actually, it represents your word into n grams characters. N grams means you have a word like machine. Okay. Suppose here I have chosen n as a 3, means I have to split this word into a 3 trigram, okay, or a 3 gram, we say in this in NLP for this. And means basically here we try to divide our this word into a small kind of set of characters. Okay, so here the opening and closing brackets are represented by your angle brackets, and here as we have taken n equal to 3, then we can put the initial two characters, then we can move by one, and we can have the MAC as our next sample in our training data. So in this way, it is going to represent your words in means it is going to represent your data in your training set. Okay. And this representation is going to help us, because actually, if you see what are the advantages, then you can realize that it works well on the rare words. And we have seen the drawback of word to vec model, that for the out of word dictionary words, it is not means it cannot capture the representation for that word, but fast text model is going to capture capture that representation for the unknown words also. So this is how n grams are implemented to improve